everyone and welcome back to the channel. My name is Shashank Parmar and in this today's video we will talk about the crime scene management. So let's begin with the famous sentence that not all physical evidences arises from the crime scenes, but all the crime scenes create physical evidences. So first of all, we will see what is the crime scene. Crime scene is place where crime has occurred. Crime scene मतलब वो जगह जहाँ पे हमारा क्राइम हुआ है. Crime scene can be any place. Crime scene can be a car. Crime scene can be a home or even under a water. Each crime scene is unique because the chain of events that created is unique. But there are some unifying themes, unifying theories that dictate how a crime scene is studied and processed. Now we will look into the classification of the crime scene. Crime scenes are divided into the two. First of all is the primary crime scene and the second one is the secondary crime scene. There is also a crime scene which is based on the location. Now first of all, that is a primary crime scene. Primary crime scene is the site of the original or first criminal activity as the primary crime scene. वो जगह जगह जहाँ पे सबसे पहले क्राइम हुआ हो उसे हम प्राइमरी क्राइम सीन कहेंगे. Now the secondary crime scene. Any subsequent crime scenes related to the primary crime scene or a place where evidence collected related to the primary crime scene. वो जगह जो प्राइमरी क्राइम सीन से रिलेटेड है और या तो फिर वो जगह पे प्राइमरी क्राइम सीन से रिलेटेड कोई भी एविडेंस मिलता है तो उसे हम सेकेंडरी क्राइम सीन कहेंगे. फॉर एग्जांपल, अगर किसी को कोई अपार्टमेंट में मार दिया जाए फिर वो बॉडी को हम किसी कार में कहीं जाके डंप कर दें तो वो कार हमारा सेकेंडरी क्राइम सीन होगा और जिस अपार्टमेंट में उस बॉडी को मारा है वो हमारा प्राइमरी क्राइम सीन होगा. यूजिंग दिस क्लासिफिकेशन, अ सिंगल मैक्रोस्कोपिक क्राइम सीन सच एज अ हाउस में एक्चुअली बी कंपोज्ड ऑफ मेनी स्मॉलर और माइक्रोस्कोपिक क्राइम सीन्स. मतलब ये क्लासिफिकेशन यूज करके हम बता सकते हैं कि जो कोई घर जो हमारा क्राइम सीन है उसमें भी बहुत छोटे छोटे क्राइम सीन्स हो सकते हैं. For example, a gunshot victim's body dumped in a field represents the following crime scenes within the overall crime scene of the field. So the body is the crime scene, the body's wound are the crime scene, and the ground around the body can be a crime scene. The microscopic classification of the scene is more focused on the specific types of physical evidences found in the macroscopic crime scenes. Each macroscopic crime scenes has various microscopic classifications of crime scene in it. Using the previous examples, the microscopic crime scenes are the trace evidence on the body, the gunshot residue around the wound, and the tire tread marks in the ground next to the body all are included in the crime scene. Now we will look into the steps to the scientific examination of a crime scene. First of all is the recognition. Recognition includes scene survey, documentation, and the collection and preservation of evidences. Second comes is the identification. Identification has comparison testing in it of the evidences. Third one is the individualization, which includes evaluation and interpretation of the evidences. Fourth one is the reconstruction, reporting and presentation of the crime scene and the crime. Response to the crime scene. Initial response to the crime scene should be done very carefully and in a proper method. The initial responding officer upon arrival shall assess the scene and treat the incident as a crime scene. They shall promptly yet cautiously approach and enter the crime scene, remaining observant of any persons, vehicles, events, potential evidence, and the environmental conditions. Here are the list of some of the duties which initial responding officer should do. First of all, note or log the dispatch information. For example, address, that is location, time, date, type of call, and the parties involved. Second, be aware of any persons or vehicles leaving the crime scene. Then approach the scene cautiously. Scan the entire area thoroughly, assess the scene, and note any possible secondary crime scenes. Be aware of any persons and vehicles in the vicinity that may be related to the crime. Make initial observations. Look, listen, and smell to assess the scene and ensure officers' safety before proceeding. Remain alert and attentive. Assume that the crime is ongoing until determined to be otherwise. मतलब कि जब तक पता ना चले कि क्राइम हो चुका है या फिर अब आगे कुछ नहीं होगा तब तक अलर्ट रहना है और चौकन्ना रहना है. Treat the location as a crime scene until assessed and determined to be otherwise. Now, safely direct additional responding units into the area. Now, the role of first responding officer. The duties of first responders include the following: assess the victim, prevent any changes to the victim, search for and arrest the suspects if that person is still on the scene, detain any witnesses, if possible, keep the witnesses separated to preserve their objectivity, do not take them back to the scene if at all possible, protect and secure the crime scene, begin taking crime scene security measures by using barrier tapes, which is yellow colored mostly, and official vehicles or other means as required. Establish a crime scene security log to record any person who enters or exit the crime scene and limit access to those who truly need it. मतलब जो क्राइम सीन है वहां पे एक लॉग रखो, नोट रखो कि कौन क्राइम सीन में आता है और कौन क्राइम सीन से बाहर जाता है, और उसी पर्सन को अलाउ करो जो जिसकी वहां पे नीड हो, जिसकी वहां पे जरूरत हो. डॉक्यूमेंट ऑल द मूवमेंट्स, अल्टरेशंस और चेंजेस मेड टू द क्राइम सीन एंड पास दिस इंफॉर्मेशन टू द क्राइम सीन इन्वेस्टिगेटर्स. क्राइम सीन पे हर एक चेंजेस, हर एक मूवमेंट की इंफॉर्मेशन जो क्राइम सीन इन्वेस्टिगेटर होता है उसे पास ऑन करनी होती है. Now, securing the crime scene. First of all, establish boundaries of the scene, starting at the focal point and extending outwards, include where the crime occurred, potential points and paths of exit and entry of suspects and witnesses, place where the victim or evidence may have been moved. Be aware of trace and impression evidences while accessing the crime scene. Trace evidence और impression evidence का हमें ध्यान इसलिए रखना होता है ताकि वो contaminate ना हो जाए और damage ना हो जाए. Second, secure the scene. Set up physical barriers as discussed previously, like ropes, cones, crime scene barrier tapes, available vehicles, personals and other equipments, or use existing boundaries, for example doors, walls and gates. Document the entry and exit of all people entering and leaving the scene once boundaries have been established. Protect the scene, control the flow of personnel and animals entering and leaving the scene to maintain the integrity of the scene. Institute measures to preserve and protect evidence that may be lost or compromised. For example, protect them from the rain, snow, or wind, and even from the footsteps, tire tracks, and sprinklers. Document the original location of the victim or any objects that you observe being moved. Consider search and seizure issues to determine the necessity of obtaining consents to search and or obtaining a search warrant. Now, the role of investigating officers. Role of investigating officers are to conserve with the first responder regarding observations. मतलब जो first responding officer था उसके पास से सारी information लेना, data entry, logs, everything from the first responding officer. It's the first duty of the investigating officer. Evaluate safety issues that may affect all persons entering the scenes. For example, blood, bone, pathogens, and hazards. Evaluate search and seizure issues to determine the necessity of obtaining consents to search and or obtain a search warrant. Evaluate and establish a path of entry-exit to the scene to be utilized by authority personnel. मतलब एक पाथ क्रिएट करना है जहां पे एंट्री और एग्जिट हो सके क्राइम सीन में और जो प्रॉपर एंड सेफ हो. इवैल्यूएट इनिशियल सीन बाउंड्रीज. डिटरमाइन द नंबर ऑफ सीन्स एंड प्रायोरिटाइज टू एस्टैब्लिश अ सिक्योर एरिया विद इन क्लोज प्रॉक्सिमिटी टू द सीन्स ऑफ द पर्पस ऑफ कंसल्टेशन एंड इक्विपमेंट स्टेजिंग. If multiple scenes exist, establish and maintain communication with personnel at those locations. To establish a secure area for temporary evidence storage in accordance with rules of evidence, that is chain of custody. मतलब temporary evidence storage के लिए जगह रखनी है जहां पे सारे evidence एक साथ रख सके और वहां पे chain of custody मेंटेन करनी है. टू डिटरमाइन एंड रिक्वेस्ट एडिशनल इन्वेस्टिगेटिव रिसोर्सेस एज रिक्वायर्ड टू एंश्योर कंटिन्यूड सीन इंटीग्रिटी. मतलब सीन प्रॉपर रखना है, डॉक्यूमेंटेशन प्रॉपर रखना है. देन टू एंश्योर दैट विटनेसेस टू द इंसिडेंट्स आर आइडेंटिफाइड एंड सेपरेटेड. मतलब क्राइम सीन पे जो भी लोग प्रेजेंट है उसमें से विटनेसेस को हमें अलग से रखना है ताकि उनसे बाद में वेरिफिकेशन और इंक्वायरी हो सके. इंश्योर द सराउंडिंग एरिया एंड इज कैन इंश्योर द सराउंडिंग एरिया इज कैनवास्ड एंड द रिजल्ट्स आर डॉक्यूमेंटेड. इंश्योर प्रिलिमिनरी डॉक्यूमेंटेशन, फोटोग्राफी ऑफ द सीन एंड इंजर्ड पर्सन्स एंड व्हीकल्स. नाउ द सेफ्टी फॉर द क्राइम सीन इन्वेस्टिगेटर्स. Crime scene investigators wear latex gloves, that is double gloved, and they use protective shoe covers. The use of a particle respirator, goggles, or face shields is recommended in addition to the minimum protective items when potentially infectious dust or mist are present. When processing or collecting evidences, personnel should be alert to sharp objects, knives, hypodermic syringes, razor blades, and similar sharp items. Personnel should maintain a red biohazard plastic bags for the disposal of contaminated gloves, clothing, mask, pencils, wrapping papers, and so on. All non-disposable items such as overalls or lab coats should be removed, placed in properly marked linen bags for laundering by an appropriate services. Documentation. Crime scene documentation is done to परमानेंटली रिकॉर्ड द कंडीशंस ऑफ द क्राइम सीन एंड इट्स फिजिकल एविडेंस। मतलब क्राइम सीन की हर एक इंफॉर्मेशन और फिजिकल एविडेंस की हर एक इंफॉर्मेशन परमानेंटली रिकॉर्ड करने के लिए करते हैं। इट इज द मोस्ट टाइम कंज्यूमिंग एक्टिविटी एट द सीन एंड रिक्वायर्स द इन्वेस्टिगेटर टू स्टे ऑर्गेनाइज्ड एंड सिस्टमैटिक। हियर द प्रॉब्लम सॉल्विंग स्किल्स, इनोवेशंस एंड ओरिजिनलिटी विल ऑल्सो बी नीडेड। द फोर मेजर टास्क ऑफ डॉक्यूमेंटेशन आर फर्स्ट नोट टेकिंग, वीडियोग्राफी, फोटोग्राफी एंड स्केचिंग। ऑल दिस फोर आर नेसेसरी एंड नन इज एन एडिक्वेट सब्स्टिट्यूट फॉर अनदर। फॉर एग्जाम्पल्स, नोट्स आर नॉट सब्स्टिट्यूट ऑफ फोटोग्राफी एंड वीडियो इज नॉट अ सब्स्टिट्यूट ऑफ स्केचिंग। ईच टूल मस्ट बी अप्लाइड वेन एंड वेयर नीडेड टू गिव एज अ कंप्लीट रिकॉर्ड एज पॉसिबल। So first of all, we will begin with the note-taking procedure. Effective notes as a part of crime scene investigation serves as a written record of all the crime scene activities. मतलब note-taking जो होता है वो crime scene पे हुई हर एक activity की note रखता है, हर एक information उसमें होती है। The notes are taken as the activities are done so they are not subject to memory loss at a later time. अगर बाद में कोई एक्टिविटी हुई और उसे कोई भूल गया तो वो ना हो इसलिए नोट टेकिंग करते हैं। A general guideline for note taking is to consider the W's. Who मतलब कौन, what मतलब क्या, when मतलब कब, where मतलब कहां पे, and why मतलब क्यों। In addition to the following, notification information, note that it notes the date, time, method of notification and information received. All these information are noted. First of all, arrival information. Here note the means of transportation, date and time, personnel present at the scene and any notifications to be made. Then comes the scene description. Note the weather, location, type and condition, major structures, identification of transient and conditional evidences, containers holding evidences of recent activities. For example, ashtrays, trash cans and many more. Clothing, furniture and any weapons present at the crime scene. Then the victim description. In most jurisdictions, the body should never be moved. मतलब body जो dead body है, कोई भी body हो, वहाँ से हिलने नहीं चाहिए. Or disturbed until the medical examiner has given approval. मतलब कि जहाँ तक medical examiner ने approval ना दिया हो, तब तक crime scene पे से body हटेगी नहीं. Once given permission, then note victim position, wounds, clothing, jewelry or identification for its presence or absence. Then the crime scene team. Note assignments to the team members, walkthrough informations, beginning and the ending times and evidence handling results. Accurate crime scene note taking is crucial at the initial crime scene investigation, but it is also essential for any subsequent investigations that may follow. Videography. Video recording, that is videography of the crime scene, has become a routine procedure for crime scene documentation. Its acceptance is widespread due to its ability to provide a virtual image of the scene and the increased availability of affordable equipment with user-friendly features such as DVD recordings. The following summarizes the process that should be followed for the effective videotaping of the crime scene. Document the recording by use of a placard that includes the case number, date and time, location and the videographer's name. Begin with the scene surroundings. Include roads to and from the scene before taping, the general view of the scene itself. Here, use the four compass points as a guide. Provide a general orientation of the scene. Videotape the orientation of items of evidence in the relation to the overall scenes. Wide-angle views are especially useful. Do not jump from one location to another. Instead, here use a smooth transition that encompasses the overall location of the evidences. Records the victim's viewpoint. It's the most important. Move to a safe location near the victim and record the four compasses points viewed away from the victim. Camera technique should include smooth movements. You can use a tripod or a monopod if possible. Use additional lightings for all the interior scenes, which the most cam recorders have low light automatic aperture corrections, but additional lighting is suggested. Once videotaping has been completed, review it on the scene and reshoot the scene as needed. The original videos are evidences and should not be edited or changed. Make copies when needed. Video recording of the crime scene is a vulnerable tool for providing an overall accurate impression of the crime scene that often cannot be accomplished by other documentation tasks. However, it is never an adequate substitute for any of the other tasks. Photography. Photographs are the most fragile area of the crime scene first. Photograph all the stages of the crime scene's investigation, include discoveries. Photographs are the evidence in detail and include a scale, the photographer's initials and the date. Photograph the interior crime scene in an overall and overlapping series using a wide-angle lens. Photograph the important evidences twice. A medium distance for the photograph that shows the evidence and its position to other evidence. A close-up photograph that includes a scale and fills the frame. The following are the basic equipment needed for the photographic documentation of crime scene. First of all, the camera with 35mm is the most common type. Normal lens up to 50 to 60mm. Then wide angle lens, an electronic flash card, flash with card and a tripod. Sketching a crime scene is the assignment of the units of measurements. Relevant physical evidence are identified within the scene. Sketching a crime scene is not difficult, but it requires some organization and planning by the investigator. There are two types of sketches of crime scene. First of all is the rough sketch, and the second one is the final sketch. We can say finished sketch or final sketch. There are three techniques that can be used to obtain the measurements for the crime scene sketch. First of all is the triangulation. Second one is the baseline, or we can say the fixed line. And the third one is the polar coordinators. Let's understand with the help of diagram. See here in the triangulation, point X and Y are fixed. Here the evidences A and B are measured from point X and the Y. Then the baseline method. Here the point X and Y are fixed and evidence A and B are measured along the line between X and Y and at the right angles to the X and Y line. Then the last method, that is polar coordinates. Here the object A is a distance from wall X is 30 degrees southwest. Here in this polar coordinates method, compass is used for the measurement of the angles. Here in the two diagrams, you can see the above one is the rough sketch of a crime scene. And the second one is the finished sketch, or we can say the final sketch of the crime scene, where everything is properly marked and labeled. Now, the crime scene searching methods. After the completion of the crime scene documentation and intensive search of the scene for physical evidences, and the collection and the preservation of the evidence can begin. There are some methods from crime scene searching are as follows. First of all is the link method. Second one is the line, or we can say strip method. Third one is the grid method. Fourth one is the zone method. Fifth is wheel method, which can also be known as ray method. And the sixth one is the spiral method. Link method. This method is not a geometric pattern, or we can say it is easily definable. Here there is no set patterns. This method is used to find link between the evidences. Here the investigator evaluates the scene and then proceed through the area in a systematic and logical fashion, based on the notion that one type of evidence leads to the another. Here this method works with large and small indoor and outdoor crime scenes. Then let's see the next method, that is line method, or we can also say that is strip method. Here in the diagram you can see all the arrows pointing toward the right side, which means the investigation is started from the left towards the right side. It is used on large and outdoor crime scenes. Here the members of the search team are usually arranged at regular intervals and usually arm's length. That means the one arm distance, or we can also say the one hand distance. Then they proceed to search along the straight lines. Then there is a grid method. Here you can see the investigation search starts from the left to right and from top to bottom. This is also used on large and outdoor crime scenes. Searchers follow the first line pattern and search in the same manner as the line method. Once the first line pattern is complete, searchers realign on the other line patterns. Then is the zone method. Here we can say that crime scene are distributed into four zones, that is 1, 2, 3, and 4. Here it is used on the crime scenes that are comprised of readily definable zones, such as in houses or buildings. Teams are assigned small zones for searching, and then other appropriate searching methods are employed in each zones. Then we will see that spiral method. It can be inward or outward. This is used with no physical barriers, such as with open water. It can either begin at critical point of crime scene, that is outward spiral, or the outer edge of the crime scene, that is the inward spiral. Then the last method, which is wheel or ray method. This is used in small and circular crime scenes. Here the investigator starts from critical point and travel out toward along many straight lines from this point. Now let's see the golden rules. For the searching method. Here there are three rules in it. Search area should be determined to maximum concentration. Each area should no more than 20 to 40 minutes to search. मतलब कोई भी क्राइम सीन को मतलब कोई भी मेथड यूज कर रहे हो उसे उस जोन को उस मेथड को यूज करने में 20 से 40 मिनट से ज्यादा लगने नहीं चाहिए. ब्रेक्स should be taken after each search for at least 10 minutes. हर एक सर्च के बाद थोड़ा ब्रेक होना चाहिए, at least 10 मिनट का. Search the same area twice so that nothing is overlooked. Collection and packaging of evidences. Forceps and similar tools may have to be used to pick up small items. Unbreakable plastic pill bottles with pressure leads are the excellent containers for the hair, glass, fiber, and other kind of trace evidences. Most items of evidence at a crime scene will be packaged in a primary container that is placed inside a secondary container. Druggist folds are especially well suited as a primary containers for trace evidence collection and packaging. These folds are then placed inside outer containers such as envelopes, packets, canisters, papers, and plastic bags. Now we will see about the chain of custody. It is a list of all persons who came into possession of an item of the evidence. मतलब जिन लोगों के पास evidence आया, उन सभी लोगों का data उस chain of custody में होता है. The chain of custody must be established whenever evidence is presented in the court. Adherence to standard procedures in recording its location, marking it for identification, and properly completing evidence submission forms for laboratory analysis is critical. Every person who handled the evidence and where it was at all time must be documented. Now we will see the role of police. Role of police is to investigate the case, arrest the suspect, collect the evidences, keep the peace, prevent the crime, provide social services, to maintain the public order, to protect the rights and freedoms of an individual, apprehend the offenders, and it is his or her duty to prevent all the courts. Judiciary system. In India, the Supreme Court is the highest authority of the judiciary. Now, the components of the court. Components of the court are judge, defense lawyer, and a public prosecutor. Now, what is the role of a judiciary? The judiciary in India performs various important roles and functions which do not remain confined with the traditional jurisdiction of civil and criminal. First of all, to prevent of violation of law. Making of the new law. It decides on constitutional questions, interprets the constitutions and laws. Its administrative functions, advisory functions, and it also helps in protection of the fundamental rights. It is the guardian of the constitution. Now let's understand about the role of fire brigade. Fire brigade promotes the fire safety, fighting fires and protecting people and property from the fires. Sometimes crime scene may be also at the place where there is huge fire, rescuing people from road traffic accidents, dealing with other specific emergencies such as flooding or terrorist attacks. In prevention of fire, fire brigade are the first person that are called to provide emergency medical. To provide symptoms of poisoning and nature of poison consumed by the diseased, collection of blood for DNA and blood groupings, hair as a specimen sample, to establish linkage between human organs, whether it belongs to the same individual or not. Now let's understand the other forensic experts and the role. Role of explosive expert. To handle the live bomb, it's the main task of explosive expert. Handling of live bomb, its mechanism, its type, then diffusing of a live bomb at a standard measures, then to know about the explosive material used in it, and to ascertain the effectiveness and the fatal intensity of a bomb, to find out nature and type of residue materials of an explosive, all these things are done by an explosive expert. Role of fingerprint expert. To search for possible fingerprints on doors, windows, tables, utensils, glass and car, and many more places where fingerprints can be found. To develop and make latent fingerprints visible. To take a proper photographs with proper scale and marking. Then lifting and develop fingerprints from immovable objects. Then comparison of fingerprints taken from crime scene with searching for drugs and explosive with the suspect's fingerprint. To maintain fingerprints record with appropriate classifications. Then role of the ballistic expert. It's like identification of firearms and its working. Then caliber of firearm, cartridges, bullets, pellets, and wads. All these are the parts of a firearm. Here the ballistic expert does is to understand its properties and its identification from firearm. Then identification of firearm shooter through gunshot residues. Then understanding the distance and angle of fire. Establishing of a gunshot injuries, wounds of entry and exit. To locate the projectile scattered at the crime scene. To decide the case as a homicide, suicide or an accident. Role of photography expert. To make complete and accurate record of the crime scene. To establish exact location of various objects including the dead body at the crime scene. Searching of micro traces and hidden evidences with the help of UV, IR photographic techniques. Photography and videography during post-mortem of the dead body. To prepare photographic evidences such as fingerprints, footprints, tire marks, shoe prints, tool marks and many more others. Then taking a close-up photography of wounds and injuries such as entry wounds of the bullet with marks such as burning, blackening and singeing. Then to record evidences found on the body. Recordings of activities of criminals during crime in actions such as riots, demonstrations, arsons and many more. The dog's active sense of smell, sight and hearing have a decisive advantage over the human agencies and are put to use for assisting the police in a variety of investigations and search operations. Dogs could be used with substantial success in tracking the criminals after a crime has been committed and in searching premises to locate criminals. Dogs could be used for recovering articles stolen, searching for missing persons, and for patrolling, explosives and narcotic detections, and VIP and VVIP security. In searching for drugs and explosives, locating missing peoples, finding crimes in evidences, attacking people targeted by the police. Recently, the Delhi police has recruited many of the city's street dogs to be trained for security purposes. Thank you so much for watching our video. I hope you liked it. If you liked it, make sure to like the video and subscribe the channel and hit the bell icon for the notification of our next videos. And for the more content, you can also visit our website, that is www.thesaihub.in. Thank you so much again.